translate for you.
Felicity, it's been a while.
Hello, Lou. This is Felicity. I'm ready. Please go ahead.
Thank you. Today's testimony is called Broken.
老师今天的见证分享题目是破碎。
I was in the Dollar Tree store last night.
昨天晚上我在一元店。
And there was a lady and two kids behind me in the long line.
有一位女士和她的两个孩子在我的后面排着长队。
One was a big kid and the other was a toddler.
其中一个是较大的孩子了，另一个则是蹒跚学步的孩子。
The bigger one had a pack of glow sticks.
大孩子有一盒会发光的荧光棒。
And the toddler was screaming for them.
蹒跚学步的小孩子尖叫着，也想要荧光棒。
The mom opened the pack and gave him one, which stopped his tears.
妈妈为了让那个小孩子停止流泪，停止哭泣，就打开盒子，拿了一根荧光棒给他。
He walked around with it smiling.
小朋友就微笑着走来走去的。
But then the bigger boy took it and the toddler started screaming.
但是后来大一点的那个男孩子拿走了他的荧光棒，那个蹒跚学步的小孩子又开始尖叫了起来。
Just as the mom was about to fuss, the older child bent the glow stick and handed it back to the toddler.
就在那个妈妈正要大发脾气的时候，大一点的孩子就把那个发光的，把那个荧光棒弯曲的折了一下，便立马把那个荧光棒还给了小一点的那个孩子。
As we walked outside at the same time, the toddler noticed that the stick was now glowing.
当我们走到外面的同时，那个小孩子就注意到了荧光棒此刻正在发光。
His brother said, I had to break it so that you could get the full effect from it.
他的哥哥就对他说，我必须要打破它，这样子你才能够从中看到它充分发光的那个效果。
I almost had to run because I could hear God saying to me, I had to break you to show you why I created you.
我几乎要逃走了，因为我能够听到上帝对我说，我必须要打破你，将你破碎，彻底的破碎。
You had to go through it so I could fulfill your purpose.
好让你知道，我为什么创造了你，你必须要经历这样的破碎，这样子你才能够实现你被造的目的。
That child was happy, just swinging that unbroken glow stick around in the air.
那个可爱的孩子就很高兴地在空中挥舞着那根完好无损的荧光棒。
He didn't understand what it was created for. It was created to glow.
但是他并不知道它是用来发光的。
There are some people who are just being, but some of us are chosen, we have to be broken.
有些人只会满足于存在，但有些人是被上帝所拣选的，我们必须要经历被破碎。
We have to get sick, we have to lose a job, we have to go through a divorce, we have to bury a spouse, parents,best friend or a child.
我们必须要生病，有时不得不生病，我们不得不失去一份工作，或者我们离婚了，或者我们必须要埋葬我们的配偶，或者是父母，或者是最好的朋友， 甚至或者是我们的孩子。
In those moments of desperation, we were broken.
在那些绝望的时刻，我们几乎崩溃，被破碎到几乎要崩溃。
But when the breaking is done, then we are able to see the reason for which we were created.
但是当被破碎完成之后，我们将能够看到我们被造的原因。
So when others see you glowing, know that you have been broken for God's perfect divine purpose.
所以当其他人看到你发光的时候，就会知道你被就会知道你被破碎是为了上帝完美的、非凡又极美的目的而被破碎的。
I don't know who wrote this, but God sure did use it to touch my heart when I read it on Facebook.
我不知道这是谁写的，但是我在脸书上读到这篇文章的时候，上帝确实触动了我的内心。
How many times does God use our brokenness to make us whole again?
Please go ahead.
How many times does God use our brokenness to make us whole again?
曾几何时，上帝多少次利用我们的破碎，又重新使我们被建造。
I know in my life he has many times over and over again.
我深知道在我的生活中，上帝已经很多遍很多遍，一次又一次这样子做了。
Whenever I face a trial that cuts deep to my soul, he gently reminds me He's all I need, and He restores my brokenness.
每当我要面对一场连灵魂都要被划破的考验的时候，上帝都会温柔地提醒我，他自己就是我所需要的一切，并要使我已经被破碎的可以得以恢复和复原。
His grace covers us in those times, and we just need to rest in Him.
在那些时日，上帝的恩典是我们的避难所，庇护着我们，我们只需要在他里面休息。
I've personally at times had to tell the devil to get out in Jesus' name.
我个人有的时候不得不奉耶稣的名警告撒旦魔鬼，撒旦退去吧。
It is a powerful weapon that every Christian has through Jesus.
这是我们借着耶稣而拥有的强大武器。
I need Jane now because I need to add something that God yesterday just again broke me. And I had already sent this and I need Jane to add for me. Can you do that?
我想要跟大家讲一下，就是就在昨天上帝又打破了我，打碎了我。Go ahead.
I have asked y'all to pray for my granddaughter and the middle son who has denied that God exists, even though he was raised in a Christian home.
Okay, 我想要 your second son, right? Okay, 我想要跟大家讲的就是说我的第二个儿子哈，虽然他出生在我们这个基督教的家庭里面，但是他拒绝接受神，这个是让我非常心碎的。
My granddaughter is 6 years old.
And, 我的孙女儿是六岁大。
She came to visit. We had a belated birthday celebration because where I was sick, I couldn't be with her on her birthday. So they came to visit yesterday and we had a little party for her.
所以昨天的时候，这个孙女呢就来他们家玩，然后呢顺便帮她办一个补办一个生日会。
My youngest son Jesse had a Christian T-shirt on and had a Bible verse, and it was talking, "Don't worry, God has it under control," or something to that effect. But anyway, it had God and talking about was in control.
Okay, Jesse身上就穿了一件T恤，这个T恤上面呢写的字好像大概就是说。 有神的字样，有说就是说神会把掌管一切，一切都在他的控制之下，这样子大概有这么一个字眼。有里面有讲到神啊，有讲到神掌管一切啊，这样子。She
read the T-shirt. She reads exceptionally well for her age. And a little while later, we were having her cupcakes, and she started a conversation. Who's God? She doesn't even know who God is. They won't even share with her. And her mother said, "All right, who wants to take that one on?"
Okay, so 这个小孙女儿哈，她因为她六岁，但是在她的年纪里面，她算是挺会阅读的哈，她的词汇量够的，她看得懂那个 T-shirt 上的字，所以她就在问，她说。 那个上面写的字，因为上面有一个 God，他说那个是谁呀？谁是神呢？谁是 God 啊？OK， 那当时陆老师就很心碎，他说：“哎呀，他的父母居然都没有教这个孩子谁是神这样子。”Go ahead.
So in a short span, you know, I explained who God was, but I mean, there's no way to give the message of salvation at that point because you know we're sitting around the table and our father. You know, he is so anti-Jesus. But I asked the question, I said, can I send her a book and will you read to her that it explains who Jesus is? And my mom spoke up and said, you know, Ashley, in today's world, it is so important that we accept him as Savior because we see prophecy fulfilling and we know Jesus is coming soon. I mean, you just know time on this earth is growing short. And hung her head down and said, yes, I promise we will read it to her and she will read it, but we will make sure she reads it and understands it.
Who
Ashley's her mom.
Her mom, okay. 所以当时呢，他看了陆老师看了很难过，因为这个孩子都不知道神是谁，所以陆老师就说，我们可不可以寄一本书给这个孩子啊？然后我为这个孩子读这个书，告诉他耶稣基督是谁，神是谁这样子。然后当时陆老师的母亲也说，在这个末世的时候，其实，真的也是要认识神才能知道，救恩啊，才能知道救恩。这个孩子呢？ 可这个孩子，因为他的父母从来没有跟他解释过，神什么的，所以他根本也没有办法知道救恩。然后，陆老师的母亲也是说，在这个末世的时候，人非常需要知道救恩，非常需要认识神的啊。然后当时呢，这个孩子的母亲坐在旁边就说：“好，我们会把这本书念给他听，念给这个孩子听，让他认识上帝。” OK, go ahead.
My brokenness is from a granddaughter. And of course, Justin and Ashley to know Jesus. But for they're so wrong. And because of that wrong decision, their daughter faces eternity in hell. That is the reality. If they don't share and tell her about Jesus, because she's quickly becoming to the age of accountability. I was 7 years old when I accepted Jesus as Savior. She just turned 6. So that's why it's so important for parents to teach their children when they're young.
所以陆老师是非常难过啊，因为 陆老师想到说，这个就是因为他的父母没有介绍给他，因为这个孩子的父亲啊是很反对基督的哈，所以不愿意介绍给孩子这个有关于神的事情啊，基督的事情。那就是因为这个父母亲他们没有这样做，没有介绍给孩子。但是你知道，孩子那时候已经现在已经六岁了。陆老师讲到他自己，他说他自己是在七岁的时候就认识神了，所以孩子已经到了要认识神的时候，绝对是可以认识神的时候。可是你没有介绍，就因为你没有把神啊让这个孩子将来要去下地狱的话，真是，所以陆老师觉得心里非常非常的难过。Go ahead.
If you all would remember little Addie in your prayers, that somehow we can get the message of salvation to her and let her know about Jesus, I would appreciate it. And before we, if you can tell them I ended this, that God bless each of you. And my heart prayer is for your protection and continued desire to grow closer to the Lord.
So you,真的要把上帝介绍给孩子，让孩子彻彻底底认识神，才会有这个救恩，才能引领他们将来进入天堂。所以神就是今天陆老师特别强调，就是在祷告里面我们真的是要纪念这件事情。 OK, go ahead.
You can play this song.
OK, sure. 好，我们现在来听这首歌哈，这是陆老师特别选的这首歌，叫《恩典》。
I am redeemed by grace. By grace I am redeemed. By grace I am restored. And now I freely walk into the arms of Christ my Lord.
Okay.
That song.
Wonderful. That's a wonderful song. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay. Back to the host.
Thank you, Lou. Okay. Now please read the Lord's Prayer. Thank you.
Our Father in heaven.
Our Father
in heaven. Hallowed be your name.
Hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done.
Your kingdom come,
your will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread.
Give us today our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts.
And forgive us our debts.
As we have also forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation. But deliver us from the evil one.
Thank you, Lou. Thank you, Felicity, for translating. Welcome. Thank you.
Bye. I'll see y'all Wednesday.
Okay.
I'm working on a devotion about Noah for Wednesday, so heads up.
Jay.